Thank you. Good morning. Welcome to this service, and we are going to start with a prayer today. Recognizing that we all come from a variety of religious traditions and spiritual understandings, if prayer is not a part of that tradition for you, then I invite this to be a moment of pause and still in what is otherwise a busy day. But if prayer is a part of that tradition for you, then I invite you to pray with me. Creator God, author of knowledge, source of wisdom and truth, sacred presence with us today for this celebration. We have gathered to honor those who graduate today from Southwestern University. We ask that you hear our prayer as we offer our deep and heartfelt thanks. For the students who today achieve an important goal and embark on new beginnings, opportunities, and challenges, may they take their skills, talents, visions, and dreams to a world hungry for justice and hope. For the faculty and staff members whose commitment to teaching has challenged their students to excel. For the families and friends whose support and encouragement were vital in the pursuit of this academic degree. Bless us all with the determination to be persons of integrity and compassion, to possess a desire for truthfulness and justice, with trust in you and with hope and great thanksgiving, we offer our prayer. Amen. You may be seated.
Good morning. Before I officially welcome all of you and start our ceremonies, I want to remind the students here that when you matriculated, I took a picture of all of you, and I promised that I would take one at your graduation, and here we are. So if you will indulge me for a moment, I will take the graduation picture I promised you some time ago.
You have to be very, very still because it's very dark. This is a practice. I'm just gonna see how this is gonna go. Hold on, just have to count. Okay, are you ready? All right, here we go. We're live. Settle. Very good. Very good. Halfway done. Thank you very much.
I will tweet that out for you if you want to see the before and after. I still have the other picture, and I will put them both out there after we finish here today. Well, now, welcome. Members of the Board of Trustees, faculty and staff, parents and families, friends, and most important of all, graduating seniors. Welcome to the 175th annual commencement of Southwestern University. I'd like to begin these proceedings by acknowledging Southwestern's faculty and staff. And so, members of the great class of 2019 and their families, I invite you to join me in expressing our profound appreciation to these dedicated educators, professionals, and mentors for their many important positive contributions to Southwestern, to their fields, and to your intellectual and personal growth through a challenging and uplifting undergraduate journey. Thank you. 11 members of the faculty and staff have had their work recognized this past year with university awards, and we honor them now. I ask that all award recipients stand as your name is called, and please hold your applause until all 11 honorees are standing. The winners of the Jess E. Purdy Excellence in Scholarly and Creative Works Awards are Jessica Hauer from History, Melissa Johnson from Anthropology, and Tracy Giuliano from Psychology. The recipient of the university's Academic Advising Award is Barbara Anthony from Computer Science. The winners of the university's Teaching Awards are Phil Hopkins from Philosophy, Joe Hauer from History, and Emily Sidnar from Political Science. Also, four individuals received the Joe S. Mundy Award for Outstanding University Service this past year. They are Josh Barrington, Lighting Technician, Melanie Hoag, Instructioner Technologist, Debbie Pauly, Director of University Events, and Willis Wiegand, Director of General Chemistry Labs. Please join me in thanking them for their outstanding hard work. On our stage is another special guest who I also wish to acknowledge, Mr. Ernest Clark, Southwestern class of 1969. Mr. Clark is celebrating his 50th anniversary of his graduation, and we are celebrating Mr. Clark as the first African-American student to graduate from Southwestern University. Mr. Clark majored in music, you can still stand. They sit down, but you can stand. Mr. Clark majored in music, studying the piano, and upon graduation began a long and impactful career as an educator, teaching music to over 36,000 students in the Dallas area. In 2009, Southwestern awarded Mr. Clark one of our highest university honors, the Southwestern University Medal. Mr. Clark, welcome back to your alma mater as we celebrate your 50-year legacy. Several of our graduating seniors are also members of the Wind Ensemble. I now invite those seniors to please join their colleagues for one last performance under the direction of Dr. Lois Ferrari. That was really fantastic. Let's give another hand for the wind ensemble and Dr. Ferrari. The Phi Beta Kappa Honor Society, founded at the birth of this nation in 1776, is the most prestigious academic honor society in America. Yesterday afternoon, 32 members of this graduating class were inducted as newest members of the Phi Beta Kappa Society. As has become our tradition, one of those students is invited to share reflections on this time of graduation. With his remarks entitled, Born a Pirate, please welcome your Phi Beta Kappa speaker, Stan Kanagiter.
Dear class of 2019, I would like to start off with taking a selfie with all of you. It is such an honor to be your Phi Beta Kappa speaker today. If you were wondering where the accent is from, I'm an international student from the Netherlands, and I would like to thank Southwestern for welcoming a Dutch pirate who is now part of this pirate crew. I would also like to thank the parents, family, and friends on behalf of the class of 2019 for all the emotional and financial support you have given us. And I would like to thank my parents, Sister Merel and Mark, who have come all the way from the Netherlands. Ik kan geen betere familie wensen. Jullie staan altijd voor me klaar, en zonder jullie stond ik hier niet. That was Dutch. I would also like to thank Southwestern for the opportunity you have given us. I want to thank the faculty in particular for the thousands of pages you have assigned us to read, the hundreds of pages you have assigned us to write, for the hours in the library and at the computer, for the blurred eyes and the cramping fingers, but also for the knowledge and perhaps the wisdom you have helped us to attain. I have always been a pirate seeking for new adventures, sailing from shore to discover a new, exciting destination. However, not everything is smooth sailing. In order for it to be an adventure, the trip needs some waves. The waves that I have crossed are the obstacles I have overcome. But to navigate a wave, you need belief, patience, and courage. At the age of 10, I was diagnosed with dyslexia. Teachers recommended me to pursue a course of manual labor, yet I believed that this learning disability wouldn't stop me. I wanted to challenge myself and prove my teachers wrong. I was determined to sail through this wave of skepticism. And ever since, I have endeavored to transcend the waves that have come my way. But most importantly, I have learned that I have to transcend myself. After floating in my pirate ship for a couple of years, studying hard and playing basketball, I faced an unexpected wave. I suffered a serious knee injury, and after seeing several orthopedic surgeons that year, I was told that there was only a 15% chance I could ever play basketball again. The odds were against me, but I knew that through hard work and patience, I would be able to step on the basketball court again. After a year of treading water and rehabilitation, I was able to step on the court again, followed by winning the Dutch National Championship and playing college basketball for Southwestern University. The wave that changed the course of my pirate ship was a terrible grade in high school. In my senior year of high school, I got a D in English. And rather staying in a safe harbor of home, I decided to turn the pirate ship around and pursue a college degree in the United States. I built up the courage and crossed the Atlantic Ocean by myself. I was looking for another wave, but not just any wave. I wanted a wave that not only challenged my English, but one that demanded the most of my academic abilities. and I found that when I dropped anchor at Southwestern University. Each wave I have navigated taught me to believe in myself, to have patience, and to show courage. I know you all have faced similar waves in your lives, waves of doubtfulness, waves of pain, and waves of insecurity, yet you are sitting here. You are sitting here because you are graduating from Southwestern University. You all should be extremely proud of what you have accomplished in the last 3 or 4 or maybe 5 years. We are all ready to dock the pirate ship, get our diploma, and set off to new adventures. However, a storm is waiting for us. A storm that is getting stronger each year, and we are not acknowledging it. We are launching from a safe harbor, and it's been easy to ignore the weather reports. But now, we are sailing into a storm. This is no squall, this is a hurricane. A hurricane named climate change, and we are the generation that must sail into the teeth of the hurricane and surmount it or drown. Living in a continually evolving society, it is imperative we have forward-thinking individuals capable of adapting to this fluctuating climate. Don't be afraid. I believe Southwestern has made us into people who are capable of effective change in a society of tomorrow. We are scholars who are passionate, innovative, and driven. We are the individuals Southwestern produces today to make an impact in the future. Whether we know it or not, we are all in the same boat. We must have the courage to sail on, but we must act now. Congratulations again, class of 2019, and let's set sail, pirates. Thank you.
An honorary degree recognizes an individual who has achieved truly exceptional scholarly, professional, innovative, or creative distinction in an activity that is consistent with the vision of Southwestern University. Today, we honor such an individual with this distinction, and I call Dr. Timothy Boone to the podium. Dr. Boone, you began your studies in the medical arts here at Southwestern University, and today you are one of the most celebrated physicians in the nation, as well as a leader in the education of tomorrow's medical doctors. After graduating from Southwestern University in 1977 with a Bachelor of Science degree in biology, you went on to earn a Master's of Science in Physiology and a PhD in Neuroscience at the University of Texas Graduate School of Biomedical Sciences at Houston. You then earned a Doctor of Medicine degree at the University of Texas Medical School at Houston before embarking upon your urology residency training at the University of Texas Southwestern Medical School in Dallas. Today, you are the chair of the urology department at Houston Methodist Hospital, which is recognized as the number one hospital in Texas for patient care. And you also serve as the co-director of its Institute for Academic Medicine. You currently hold faculty appointments at Texas A&M College of Medicine, Baylor College of Medicine, and Weill Cornell Medical College. You specialize in the treatment of patients with neurologic issues arising from many health issues, including spinal cord injury, stroke, Parkinson's disease, and multiple sclerosis. For more than 20 years, you have actively participated in the care of spinal cord injured veterans at the VA Medical Center in Houston. You are also the primary investigator for the Neuroregeneration and Bladder Sensory Science Laboratory at the Houston Methodist Research Institute. Throughout your remarkable career, you have written more than 100 research publications, given hundreds of lectures nationally, and serve as a consultant reviewer for numerous scientific journals, including the New England Journal of Medicine. Among your numerous awards and honors, you have been named one of America's top doctors by Castle Connolly Medical. Not only are you a distinguished doctor and professor, but you are also a valued member of the Southwestern community. You have mentored our students and provided them with valuable, prestigious research internship opportunities at Houston Methodist Hospital. We have also been beneficiaries of your leadership through your role as chair of our Science Center Advisory Council when the university was planning the first phase of the new Fondren Jones Science Center. Tim, you exemplify the Southwestern spirit with your dedication to uplifting lives and your commitment to teaching and learning. In recognition of your decades of effort to make individuals better and healthier versions of themselves, Southwestern University is proud to award you the honorary degree of Doctor of Sciences. By the authority granted to Southwestern University in its charter, first by the Republic of Texas in 1840, and subsequently by the state of Texas, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, and upon the recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon you, Timothy Boone, the degree of Doctor of Sciences honors causa, with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations. With his commencement address entitled, "You Can't Control the Wind, But You Can Adjust Your Sails," please join me in welcoming back to the podium Dr. Timothy Boone.
Thank you. Good morning, President Berger, members of the Board of Trustees, treasured faculty, parents, family, and friends, and the fabulous Southwestern class of 2019. Thank you for this opportunity to speak today. You've all taken on difficult assignments, passed tough exams, pored over your notes, stumbled, and learned how to get back up. I hope you learn to be humble and you gain wisdom from the stumbles, as both humility and insight from failure will guide you when you succeed. There are these two young fish swimming in the ocean, and they happen to meet an older fish swimming the other way. He nods at them and says, "Good morning, boys. How's the water?" The two young fish swim on for a bit when one of them looks at the other and says, "What the hell is water?" Like most commencement addresses, you need to have a good pithy parable, and I'm not here as your old wise fish. The point of the fish story is merely to point out that the most obvious and important realities in life are often the most difficult to talk about and conquer. The value of your diploma today from a liberal arts university like Southwestern is often represented as the place that taught you how to think. And I assume you're pretty insulted by the idea of using such a cliche as if you were stupid or something. I think the presumption, the cliche, misses the point. The water here is not about your capacity to think, but rather your graduation from Southwestern today should be what you decide to think about. Will you let your mind succumb to the constant monologue inside your head, driven by a daily barrage of hypnotic noise from everyday life, that cell phone appendage to your body? Or have you learned how to think and what it really means to exercise control over when, how, and what you will think about? Will you be conscious and aware of your choices? And will you actively choose what you pay attention to and how you construct meaning from your own life experiences? 42 years ago, I sat exactly where you are today. And I suspect a few of my professors are sitting in this audience wondering, why is he up there? First and foremost, I would not be here except for the unwavering support and sacrifice I received along the way, just as you have. From my wife, Angela, from my parents, Ted and Nell, my children, Christy, Blair, Bolton, and Connor, and my extended family, including my brother, Keith, his wife, Diane, who are also Southwestern graduates. I would be remiss if I didn't point out Dan Stoltz, my cousin, a fellow pirate and an arch advocate for this special place for learning and growth. Dan spent years blazing a trail as an inspiring physician and a healthcare leader. He's been a mentor to me. It is my prayer for all of you that you too have an inspiring mentor, that you too are blessed in the same way with a loving family and mentors along the way who seek absolutely nothing in return. As a practicing urologist for nearly 30 years, most of my stories and jokes are a little too off color to share with you today. I believe you me, I hear it all. And I want to share a recent experience with an angry patient. He returned after his vasectomy. He was very upset. When I asked him why, he said I had assured him that after this procedure, he wouldn't have any more kids. But when he got home, they were still there. So I hope to better communicate with you today. I would like to share four themes that I've come to value in the special human beings that I find working every day alongside me, who really focus on what to think in a life of service to others and finding personal growth by adhering to a discipline of self-sacrifice married to the healing art of medicine, as Dr. Berger likes to say. My themes today are: have passion for what you do, foster self-reflection, build your resilience, and show gratitude and grace of God. I could have chosen only one of these themes to speak about, but I think all four themes are critical and interdependent, and I couldn't leave one out. You need to find passion with loyalty and purpose. You need to make time for reflection, prayer or meditation, with an emphasis on compassion for yourself. Build your resilience from actively failing, and I hope you fail a lot. Using your own internal self-control, weighing that experience as a chance to learn and turn failure from a trauma to an opportunity. And finally, gratitude and grace, paying it forward and back along your journey in life. All of these require your ability to make time to choose what to think about. I hope you find a partner to share this journey with you, someone you care more about than yourself. And so you start saying we instead of I, and us when you used to say me. Atul Gawande is a surgeon, a very prolific writer, and now heads a think tank as a CEO to try to improve healthcare delivery. Atul says in a recent bestseller, Being Mortal, for human beings, life is meaningful because it's a story. A story has a sense of a whole, and its arc is determined by the significant moments in your life, like today, the ones where something happens. For me, when something happens, it usually means a change in course, a problem, a setback, or a very important decision. And I've learned to take my mind to sailing, and I promise Dan and I didn't get together on this theme. When significant moments confront me, mentally I turn to this tranquility of thought place in my mind where I make decisions. You realize that on ground, man tends to look down, but while you're sailing, your eyes are pulled to the horizon. I love to sail. I don't own a sailboat, and my skills are very rudimentary at best. But the peace and quiet of a sailboat quiets my soul. However, as the famous Latin writer Cyrus said in 85 BC, anyone can hold the helm when the sea is calm. Believe you me, and beware, it's not all calm out there. If you study the craft of sailing with your boat skimming the waves, you'll note that the captain zigs and zags, tacking the boat to capture the wind, and he's following a course. But that course is never a straight line. Beware of the tyranny of a straight line life. The winds will stall resilience, and the storms will rage, passion with purpose. So my hope for you, your sailing adventure, is that you'll look back 50 years from now and you'll see the twists and the turns and the tacks in your life, all very meaningful stories. Develop your compass and trust it. Take risks and dare to fail. Finding your passion will be your first task, because simple competence or engagement will land you in a very boring job, and your time at Southwestern will have completely missed the mark. As a late writer and slightly irreverent university professor David Foster Wallace wrote, "The most precious freedom is the attention, awareness, discipline to care for others." This will save you from your automatic default mode, which is centered on boring and routine, the frustrating pettiness found in day in and day out adult American life. Don't give in to your default mode. My second theme is mindful reflection and refuge, with a very generous compassion for yourself. A place of refuge for reflection that will provide you with a very strong foundation for resilience and all that you'll confront along the way. Find your refuge. Find a place to reset your life and make time to be quiet and actually hear yourself. Success in this arena will protect, nurture, and uplift you so you can focus on what to think. Before you take your next journey in life, whether it's work or more school, please take time to inventory your place of refuge. Your ability to take care of yourself will depend on your place of refuge to relax, recharge, pray, meditate, and reflect. Explore this place of refuge and realize that it's a place already present deep within you and not something over there, separate from you. Failure and resilience through choice, your decision, a thinking choice, seeing failure as a trauma to react to or an opportunity to respond and learn from is my third theme for you today. As Winston Churchill said, success consists of going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. Remember that. Landmark developmental research on resilience by Gaminsky, Werner, and Bonanno studied at-risk children for over 30 years. They had experienced significant stress, and they showed that 2/3 developed serious learning disabilities and behavioral problems by the age of 10, with juvenile delinquency, mental health problems, or teenage pregnancy. But 1/3 of these kids developed into very competent and caring adults. So what predicted their resilience? While luck and one strong adult bond played a significant role in success, the major element was psychological. It had to do with how the children responded to their environment. From a very young age, these resilient children tended to meet the world on their own terms. They used whatever skills they had to effectively seek out new experiences with a very positive social orientation. They remained autonomous and independent. They orchestrated their own fates using an internal locus of control, and they believed that they, and not their circumstances, affected their achievements. In fact, these children scored more than 2 standard deviations above the other 2/3 of children. They built their resilience at a very early age. Their problems didn't go away. They just found a way to see past them by controlling in a very positive way what to think about. I hope each of you have experienced failure many times on this campus. I know I did. Organic chemistry and Dr. Solon can testify to that. While the definition of failure has a negative connotation that mistakes and failure are a sign of weakness, it's probably the most important experience you had at Southwestern. And I concur with Dr. Berger. Every mistake is a teacher and holds a lesson. No doubt that failure can be frightening and very uncomfortable, but trying is still so much better than paralysis if you're willing to step out of the box and go for it. My final theme for you today is to always extend grace and gratitude to others. Gratitude will help you make sense of your past. It'll bring you peace in the moment and create your vision for tomorrow. Gratitude with grace, that spontaneous gift from God, is free and totally unexpected and undeserved. It is powerful. This is the hardest one for me to accomplish, using the power to think with gratitude while navigating Houston traffic, standing in long lines, or waiting on hold to the recorded pharmacy music message over and over when I'm trying to call in a prescription. Give thanks, take pleasure, feel successful, and please be happy for others. I leave you with this. Decisions are made by those who show up. So show up. If you have seriousness of purpose, you garner wisdom from your failures, and you serve a calling bigger than yourself, you will succeed. So from this old fish, hopefully the water you swam in here at Southwestern instilled in you the power over how and what to think. Remember, you are a citizen of this world. There are things you can do every day to lift the human spirit, to show respect and kindness, to be civil, to demonstrate moral character. The classroom where you teach, the business where you work, the neighborhood where you live, all will provide a place where your purpose will flourish when you experience helping others achieve their own potential. Today, your parents and teachers can tell you a little bit about that incredible feeling. The true beauty and wonder of places like Southwestern build people up instead of tearing them down. And I think we all agree we need a little more places like that today. For me, it was in a hospital. For 30 years, my satisfaction was to learn and teach difficult things that were valued by my patients. I liked the intimacy of being someone's doctor and the kind of person that medicine taught me to be. Your rehearsal is over. Learn to adjust your sails, stay your course, and remember you're gonna fall down many times. And in the end, all that really matters is the number of times you fall is one fewer than the times you get back up. God bless you all. God bless this special place for learning. Thank you.
Mr. Tips and Dr. Gonder, would you please join me at the podium for the conferring of the degrees to the members of the class of 2019?
Will all candidates for degrees please rise? Mr. President, on behalf of the faculty, I certify that the candidates receiving diplomas today have completed all of the requirements for their baccalaureate degrees. They are entitled to their degrees so earned with all the rights and privileges pertaining to them.
Mr. President, the faculty has recommended to the Board of Trustees that Southwestern University confer the baccalaureate degree to these candidates. I am pleased to certify that the Board of Trustees has voted to confer these degrees as recommended.
By the authority granted to Southwestern University in its charter, first by the Republic of Texas in 1840, and subsequently by the State of Texas, and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, And upon the recommendation of the faculty, I confer upon you the degree which you have earned with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto. Please be seated. We invite families and friends to stand as their graduate's name is announced. In addition to the diplomas that our graduates will be awarded, as they step off the stage, graduates will also receive a gift of welcome and congratulations from the Southwestern University Alumni Association. Candidates for baccalaureate degrees, please come forward as directed by the graduate marshals.
Lillian Hope Atkinson, Cole Allen Atterbury, Everett Matthew Barger, Anastasia B. Barrera, cum laude. Ariana Emily Barrera, magna cum laude. Tyler Robert Balt. Avery Joanne Beam, magna cum laude. Sarah Alana Beard. Mark Allen Biefeld. Malia Catherine Bell. Amory Arella Garin Bethel. Dylan Michael Beatros, magna cum laude. Braden Matthew Bishop. Abigail Nicole Boatwright, summa cum laude. Elric Edward Bonner, Jr. Diploma presented by parent Melissa Johnson, Professor of Anthropology. Kelsey Caprice Boyd. Gerald Tyler Branham. Landry Paul Bray, cum laude. Joshua Walter Brenham, magna cum laude. Claire Michelle Brissett, Paideia with distinction. Timothy Michael Broyles, Jr. Madison Aaron Beekler. Violeta Bueno, Paideia with distinction. Bethany Catherine Burka. Sarah Elizabeth Butterworth, cum laude. Isabel Calleja. Lizette Cantu. Taylor Alexis Carnes. Madeline U. Carolla, summa cum laude. Landon Ulysses Rickley Carter. Ulysses Balam Santos Castaneda. Erica Chang. Kara Joyce Chin, Paideia with distinction. Matthew Stephen Crystal. Veronica Faye Ciotti, magna cum laude. Winston Boyd Cook. Curran Natasha Quartz, Paideia with distinction. Dakota Sky Cortez, cum laude. Samuel James Cox. Sophie Balanca Daniel. Egini Albert James Daniels II, cum laude. Thomas James Davidson. Audrey Annette Davis. Valeria de la Garza. Daniela Luis de Souza, cum laude. Natalie Ann de Caesar, magna cum laude. Gabrielle Julia Dillon, magna cum laude. Jameson Aubrey Duck, cum laude. Elizabeth Marie Farwell. Kelsey Michelle Ficus, magna cum laude. Alonso Avar Fernandez. Randy Keith Flowers, magna cum laude. Armando Garcia. Jesus Ivan Garcia. John Carlo Garcia. Michaela Janelle Garcia. Stephen Nathaniel Garcia, Paideia with distinction. Mariama Gay Gary. Zachary Todd Gibson. Grace G. Nianasigamimini. Chantal Monique Faz Gonzalez, Paideia with Distinction. Joshua Isaiah Gonzalez. Alexandria Marie Gray. Paige Nicole Greenan. Lydia Michelle Gregorovich, summa cum laude. Zainab Ibrar Guven. Trin Lam Ha. Ethan Alexander Hallmark. Kaylee Catherine Hanna, magna cum laude. Christian Joseph Hansel. Shane Michael Harrison, magna cum laude. John Richard Hatton. Madison Elizabeth Haislett. Markel DeAndre Henderson. Carmen Gloria Hernandez. Lauren Mercedes Hernandez, Paideia with Distinction. Yes. Vlad John Hightower. David Brian Hill IV. Chase Jennings Hobelman. Jake Richmond Holmes. Emma Carolyn Howson. Frederick Thomas Hover. Nur Riyad Hussein. Lauren Marissa Ingram. Jillian Jessica Jean. Grant Lucas Jones, magna cum laude. Connor Brian Joyce, magna cum laude. Allison Marie Judis. Danielle Celise Kellogg, Paideia with Distinction. Cole Michael Kelly. Isabella Christina Kidd. Yeah. Chi Aaron Knight Turkin. Julia Liliana Labens. Arden Lee Langa, magna cum laude. Jonathan Paul Lorette, summa cum laude. Andrew Charles Lemoines. Yngram Demo Lynn, magna cum laude. Conrad Webb Littlefield, who will be commissioned as a second lieutenant in the United States Marine Corps at a ceremony to be held at the state capitol at the end of this month. Devin Alexandra Lucero, Paideia with distinction. Sir Spencer Javian Majors. Colin Campbell Maloney. Isabel Megan Mandelbaum, cum laude. Michaela Marie Mannion. Anna Joan Mansour. Catherine Isabel Marafa. John Thomas Merrick. Camille Marie Martin, magna cum laude. Murina Kaylin Martinez. Alicia Vasti Maraval. Stephen Christopher Mesquite. Yeah! Michaela Marie Miller, cum laude. Yeah! Justin W. Milner. Yeah! Ryan Edward Moriarty. Marissa Renee Morin. Catherine Marie Morris. Mohammed Ramesh Nadim. Dean Austin Newbeck. Gregory Michael O'Brien. Valentina Miriam Olivieri Puentes. Daniela Guadalupe Orses. Sydney Celeste Oropesa. Haley Grace Overfelt. Samantha Jess Pentecost, summa cum laude. Meredith Avery Pollock, magna cum laude. Yeah! Carly Jolyn Puska. Larissa Renee Petra Quintana. Esther Sarai Ramos. Samantha Nicole Rayo. Zachary Earl Richards. Willow Ezra Lee Riskar. Juliet Isabella Robb. John Anthony Rodriguez. Liliana Ruby Rodriguez. Jonah Matthew Roney. Jesus David Romero Jr. Olivia Bernadette Rosen, cum laude. Catherine Jean Rouse, cum laude. Zachary Todd Rowan. Cassandra Marie Science. Brenda Amy Sanchez. Isabel Jane Sapienza. Colby Ald Schmidt. Jordan Patrick Scott. Savannah Cody Scott. Jacob Augustus Searcy. Diana Yvonne Shearer, summa cum laude. Sarah Elizabeth Shields. Alyssa Celeste Silva, Paideia with distinction. Philip James Silverland. James David Smatt, Paideia with distinction. Camille Bautista Soto, Paideia with distinction. Jillianne Rochelle Spiring. Ellen K. Stacy. Luke Bailey Stanton. Kevin Bradley Stain. Morgan Elizabeth Stennett. Russell Sutherland Stith. Tamara Lynn Stremmel. Jacob Daniel Swanke. Tomas Tyler Talley III. Thomas Kyle Thompson. Deanna Kethry Tiggs. Betty New Tan. Heather Ann Turley. Lauren Michelle Valentine. Jeb Thomas Vanderwalk, cum laude. Bryce Anthony Varney. Corey Matthew Vega. Elijah Ray Velasquez, cum laude. Armando Vidana III. Kyle Patrick Wasmuth. Jared Cameron Welsh, cum laude. Justin Ray White, Paideia with distinction, cum laude. Tyler Colton Whiteley, magna cum laude. Paul Ketting Williams, cum laude. Ronnie Reagan Winter. Miranda Helena Wolk. Adam Revis Wood, magna cum laude. Hannah Maribel Wood, Paideia with distinction. Sophia Herrera Woodward, cum laude. Susan Marie Wright, Paideia with distinction. Patricia Simone Yoxel, summa cum laude. Goda Martha Zuzu Bichute. Hannah Michelle Caradia. Jordan Lee Martz. Claire Margaret Salander. Kayla Ellen Tate. Noah Grayson Garcia Berlanga. Jacqueline Nicole Bowton. Brandy Renee Campos, cum laude. Christina Costas, cum laude. Abigail Mackenzie Earl. Jordan Marie Herbert, Paideia with distinction. Quincy Prescott Holland, Paideia with distinction. Denise Huber Ramos. Quinlan Shea Kubicek, Paideia with Distinction, summa cum laude. August Olivia Laird. Catherine Elizabeth Reinierson. Armanda Lauren Schneider. Julia Michelle Tape, Paideia with Distinction. Sophia Amelia Anthony, summa cum laude. Shannon Marie Anderson. Taylor Joseph Axtell. John David Bishop. Catherine Michelle Brickerell. Danielle Nicole Butcher. Erica Rose Dubrose. Roberto Jose Garza, Paideia with Distinction. Jillian Marie Glover, cum laude. Katrina Noelle Harris, cum laude. Stan Benjamin Kanagiter, summa cum laude. Benjamin Russell Lucas. Daniel Marcus Maldonado. Gregory Quentin McDade. Richard Morrison, who will be commissioned as a second lieutenant in the United States Marine Corps in a ceremony to be held at the state capitol at the end of this month. William Bennett King Price. David Allen Marquise Quinton. Colin Andrew Scrubs, cum laude. Alyssa Nadine Slahit, cum laude. Michael Ekira Sullivan. Matthew Edward Westerland. Eunice Moinoluna Bajomo, summa cum laude. Landon Alexander Brown. Sarah Nisha Cantu. Victoria Ann Caraway, Paideia with Distinction, magna cum laude. Cassandra Grace Chang, summa cum laude. Aaron Bradley Collier, summa cum laude. Catherine Keiko Joe. Lucas Stephen Ford, cum laude. Morgan Alexandra Fortieth, cum laude. Rachel Diane Frey. Amelia Rose Fuchs. Lauren Estelle Gillespie, summa cum laude. Madison Ann Godleski. Gisela Gonzalez, paideia with distinction, cum laude. Madison Ellen Speed Granier. Samuel David Grubbs. Kevin Guzman. Joshua Kane Hicks. Aaron Shannon Hobbs, magna cum laude. Ryan Chase Horner. Chandler Lyndon Hudson Hyatt. Miriam Alejandra Ibarra, paideia with distinction. Taylor Lorraine Halimo. Margaret Virginia Leo. Kirsten Nicole Luckuck. Jonathan Emmanuel Martin. Jesse Elena Martinez. Robert Joseph Meyer, magna cum laude. Alexander Timothy Newell. Ian Aaron Orantes Orellana. Carla Gertrudes Perez. Peter Edward Robinson. Amy Marie Rodriguez, cum laude. Brittany Nicole Rohde. Chandler Diane Smith. Taylor Michelle Smithson. John Thomas Stark. Ty Carter Stubbs. Alexandria Trevino. Isabel Sonia Twerazer. Yeah. Dylan Gregory Weaver, cum laude. Hannah Joy Winkler, summa cum laude. Clarissa Lynn Berner. Elliot Cole Wood Boone. Lily K. Schielich. Haley Devlin Donnelly. Tristan Alexis Evans, cum laude. Ayande Mustafa Hall. Danby Nicole Ha. Bonnie Marie Lambert. Joan Leslie Milburn. Matthew Patrick Murphy. Seth Elijah Nicholas, Paideia with distinction. Shirlene Ong. Angelina Palacios. Emily Faith Scott. Rebecca Lorraine Sheridan. Jasper Cezai Stone. Christopher Paul Wortham Cedarjoe. Isabel Sonia Twarazer. Lee Ann Weinberg. Sophia Amelia Anthony, summa cum laude. Huikai Chen. Caitlin Ann Helmer. Marissa Danielle Shipp. Zoe Rose Juan Watts. Veronica Marie Espinosa, magna cum laude. Addie Jean Henry, cum laude. Carl Anders Lennertsen, cum laude. Trevor Todd McIntosh. Tabitha Kristen Tiemens Pangman, cum laude. Thomas Lyndon Vanderzijde. Alexander Nicholas Wilhelm, magna cum laude. Shin T.
Please join me in congratulating all these wonderful newly minted Southwestern University graduates. Now, as your first act as Southwestern graduates, I'd like to offer you the opportunity to publicly thank your family and friends who supported you here and are with you today to celebrate your amazing accomplishments. It started off a little slow, but you picked it up at the end, so that was... I'm delighted to now introduce Charles Olson, the president of the Southwestern University Alumni Association. As president, Charlie also serves as one of the two Alumni Association representatives on the Southwestern University Board of Trustees. Charlie graduated from Southwestern in 1978 with a Bachelor of Science in Political Science, and then earned a Juris Doctor degree from Baylor University School of Law. Charlie practices law in Waco with the firm Haley and Olson, representing local governments and their employees. He is certified in civil trial law by the Texas Board of Legal Specialization and is a member of the American Board of Trial Advocates. He is also an adjunct professor at Baylor Law School. Charlie has long been involved in education, having been appointed by Governor Ann Richards to the Texas State Technical College System Board of Regents, and later elected to the Waco Independent School District Board of Trustees. With his remarks entitled High Expectations, please join me in welcoming Southwestern University Alumni Council President Charlie Olson.
It's a tradition here at Southwestern that the privilege of being the first to congratulate a newly graduated class should go to those who have walked the stage before them. Now, there is no way that any one individual, no matter how tall, can say congratulations enthusiastically enough to honor this event. So the best I can do is use some numbers. On behalf of all of the graduates of Southwestern University who are in this room, and there are many, and on behalf of 10,000 living graduates of Southwestern University, let me say congratulations on what you have accomplished, and let me tell you how much we admire and respect your accomplishment. In a few minutes, you're going to leave this place, and you're going to take with you a wonderful education and a diploma to prove it. But you're also going to take something else that nobody tells you about. All graduates of Southwestern have it. Dr. Boone has it. Mr. Clark has it. All of us have it. We carry it with us all the days of our lives. And you will carry it with you all the days of your lives. And we couldn't shake it if we wanted to. That thing is an expectation. It is a high expectation. All graduates of Southwestern carry with them all the days of their life, an expectation that Southwestern will remain a great university as long as you live, and that it will do those things over time that are necessary to best serve its students and this society. This expectation is a good thing. It's a constructive thing. It's much like the high expectations that these good professors had for you that lifted you up when you first walked into this place and have moved you forward to where we are now. In addition to being an individual thing, this expectation, I would tell you that I believe, and this is this goes to our role as alumni throughout our life, I believe that this university is in many ways powered by the collective high expectation, in our case, of 10,000 living alums. We all have the same expectations for this university. Southwestern has great professors, it does. Southwestern has a remarkable president, it does. We have a great board of trustees, trust me on that, wonderful people. But human life being what it is, those faces will change in a relatively short period of time. But what stays the same is the perpetual presence of the high expectations of the graduates of this university, lifting it up and pressing it forward, pressing it to remain a great university. Now, what you do during the course of your life with your individual expectation, it's your business. It's completely up to you. What we hope you will do is join with other alumni and with the Southwestern Alumni Association to do those things, to engage in those actions that are necessary to assure that our expectations are met. It's true, I believe, for all of us, each one of you, for me, for all the graduates in this room, that our experience at Southwestern was made either possible or better because someone who came before us did this for us. And now, in the most Southwestern of ways, over the course of your lifetime, you will have the opportunity through your actions in relation to this university to return the favor. So, welcome to the Southwestern University Alumni Association. We're proud of you. We're proud to have you as members, and we look forward to working with you for many years to come to assure that our collective hopes and expectations for this university are met. The best to all of you.
I now invite the representatives of the Senior Gift Council to come forward.
Hello, I'm Marissa Morin, and this is Amari Bethel. We, along with other seniors, have represented the class of 2019 on the Student Philanthropy Council. The Student Philanthropy Council's mission is to educate our fellow students and the campus community on the importance of giving back to Southwestern, not only during our short time on campus, but also throughout our lives as alumni. As a class, our time at Southwestern has been shaped by our experiences across campus. With our senior gifts, we were able to support the various departments, organizations, and campus initiatives that we hold dear. This year, the class of 2019 has given back in record numbers to show their love and support of the place that has given us all so much. 80% of the class of 2019 made a gift to the university this year, and 63% joined the Tower Society by making a gift of $20.19. Together, we are making a significant impact on Southwestern.
In the fall of 2015, we joined with other classes on campus in a quest to establish class-endowed scholarships. The goal for each class is to build their scholarship to a minimum of $25,000 by their fifth year reunion to start supporting future Southwestern students in perpetuity. Today, we are proud to announce that with the help of our families and friends, the Class of 2019 Scholarship Fund surpassed its goal of $25,000 in the fall of 2017. Yeah. This allowed us to be the first class to endow our class's scholarship before graduation. Because of this, in the fall of 2019, a new Southwestern student will receive a scholarship in our class's name. But this is just the beginning.
In order to ensure that future students are able to enjoy the Southwestern experience that we were fortunate to have, we must continue to give back to Southwestern, not only with gifts to the university, but also with our time as volunteers. We encourage you to make a habit of supporting the programs that you believe in. At a place like Southwestern, every student, graduate, and friend is important, and so is every gift.
President Berger, on behalf of the students and families of the class of 2019 who supported this senior gift, we are extraordinarily pleased to have contributed a total of $143,783.90 to Southwestern University this year. Please accept this check as an expression of our gratitude to the faculty, staff, and students who made our experience not only possible, but meaningful. Thank you.
That's a big check. Thank you, students, alumni. The first time that we gathered together was for your matriculation in this very space on August 15th, 2015. At that time, I offered some thoughts as you were about to begin your undergraduate journey. Now, it doesn't matter if you've forgotten them, it's too late. You're no longer undergraduates and you've already earned your degrees, so don't worry about it. But I do want to emphasize a point that Dr. Boone shared earlier. And I want to offer you one last reflection as you continue your intellectual journey beyond Southwestern. Create the space for mindful solitude. Carve out moments of stillness away from both your living and electronic companions, in which you can quietly reflect on your thoughts and emotions in the present. Through those intentional moments of peace, you will not only reawaken deeper empathy and gratitude that is within us all, but you will also rediscover greater joy. Joy that will uplift and inspire you to journey forward with both wisdom and optimism. With that closing thought, my Southwestern class of 2019, may you not only continue to grow, learn, think, and create, but also in the true spirit of Paideia, continue to connect, especially with what today has just become your alma mater. Congratulations. I now invite Professor Bruce Kane to the podium to lead us in the singing of the alma mater with Veronica Espinosa, class of 2019, conducting. Please stand as you are able and remain standing for the benediction. Thank you.
The words are in your program.
Glory to the Lord.
Thank you for attending today's ceremony. Due to today's somewhat inclement weather, the senior class photo will be taken in the Walzell courts immediately following the ceremony. The graduate robe return and official diploma distribution will now be in the Bishop's Lounge in the Red and Charlene McCombs Campus Center. And we encourage all of you family and friends to meet up with your graduates there. Would you please remain standing through the recessional? A benediction is a blessing. And a lot of times people will ask you to close your eyes and bow your heads for the blessing, but today it seems appropriate to leave your heads raised, to look around one last time at your family and your friends, your professors, because today marks a closing, marks an ending. So as you begin, and before you go to continue the celebrations of today, listen now to this blessing, written by Jan Richardson and called "This Grace That Scorches Us." Here's one thing you must understand about this blessing. It is not for you alone. It is stubborn about this. Do not even try to lay hold of it if you are by yourself, thinking you can carry it on your own. To bear this blessing, you must first take yourself to a place where everyone does not look like you or think like you, to a place where they do not believe precisely as you believe, where their thoughts and ideas and gestures are not exact echoes of your own. In this place where you have gathered, wait, watch, listen. Lay aside your inability to be surprised, your resistance to what you do not understand. See then whether this blessing turns to flame on your tongue, sets you to speaking what you cannot fathom, or opens your ear to a language beyond your imagining, that comes as a knowing in your bones, a clarity in your heart that tells you this is the reason that we were made, for this ache that finally opens us, for this struggle, this grace that scorches us toward one another and into the blazing day. Today, class of 2019, you begin the next chapter in your Southwestern story. So go out from this place to begin again. Go with peace and go to be Southwestern.
Anybody have any problems?